Set sail for adventure with the Goof Troop. It's a great day for fishing, and Goofy just caught a boatload of trouble. Pete and PJ have been kidnapped by pirates, and Goofy and Max must row to their rescue. It's hilarious hijinks on the high seas as they trail the pirates to Spoonerville Island and bumble through the jungle to free their pals from the notorious Keel Haul Pete. Get on board with Goofy and Max as they race ashore to do battle with boards of burly buccaneers, dodge exploding cannonballs, and search dinghy dungeons for clues to the pirate's lair. Dig for buried treasure and solve perplexing puzzles to gain the keys needed to enter the pirate stronghold. Sneak inside and you'll face Keel Haul Pete, the terror of the tropics. Man, we do love our alliteration here at the back of the box at Capcom's Disney's Goof Troops, the video game. Developed and published by Capcom, it is Goof Troop, released in 1993. Also known as Goofy to Max, Kaizo Kojima no Daibouken. Boken? Bouken? I don't know. This is part of the Goofy franchise. Can you believe it? It is, of course, based on the show Goof Troop to a point. It features all the characters. Well, it features four of the characters. And I think that's it. It's an action-adventure game where you have to explore and solve puzzles and defeat enemies. It is single-player or multiplayer mode. Funny little bit of trivia here. This is one of the first games designed by Shinji Mikami, who directed Resident Evil just a couple of years later. Playing as Goofy or Max, we work through the five areas of the island, the beach, a village under siege, a haunted castle, an underground cabin, and the final pirate ship, where we, like I said, solve puzzles, we beat enemies, we collect items, health, extra lives, blah, 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 and continues. You pick up continues throughout the course of the game, too. The health and life system is a bit weird. You have lives, you have health, but it's weird. Health kind of gives you a hit. The more fruit you pick up, you get hits. If you fill up your hit meter with fruit, you get lives. You can pick up lives. You can pick up straight on continues. If you lose all of your lives and you're playing two player, if your second player finishes the screen and moves on to the next one, you can come back. But if all of you lose all your lives on the screen, game is over, although you can continue. Otherwise, you gotta play from the beginning of the stage using a password. Okay. In issue 51 of the magazine, Nintendo Power gave it a 3.525 out of 5. They did criticize the challenge for being fairly low, but they did say the game is still great fun. Ingo Zabrowski of Maniac gave it a 75 out of 100, which is almost the same score. And in 2013, Andy Green of Nintendo Life largely lauded the game, stating, quote, Goof Troop is an absolute gem of a game when teaming up with a friend in multiplayer. It might be short, the gameplay might be simple, and the puzzles are easy, but there's no denying it's an incredibly enjoyable experience when both members of the troop are on screen. In the same review, though, Green criticized the single-player mode, stating the simplistic nature of the game and its low difficulty level makes it tedious, and as time goes on, you'll get fed up completing puzzles that were evidently designed for more than one person. And I totally agree. I agree with the rating, and I agree with the reviews. The graphics are great. The music is great. The little jingles for anytime you do something good are a little over the top, which I love. And two-player, it is a lot of fun. It is a lot of fun. But single-player, yeah, it's kind of boring. And it's not that the gameplay itself is boring, but doing the puzzles by yourself is not an enjoyable experience, really. But the game is very fun, and well worth a try.